Now we actually have to collect the data, right? And write it in the box. So that will be how you're going to carry out today's investigation.
We want to develop kids that are great learners and great thinkers.
As a project-based learning school, we're very intentional about always going back to our essential question and saying what skills do they need and how they acquire them. We map it out on our instructional plan, but we also use it for students as their roadmap to see where their learning is going.
What else did you notice about the wrapping?
It's bumpy.
It was bumpy.
We are a PBL school. That's a project-based learning school. Our projects are done at every grade level.
Even if it doesn't work out, we're just not going to give up.
PBL is really challenging. We have a huge focus in our building with our teachers. They collaborate and plan very closely. I think that it's really important to carve out that time for them so that they can effectively get kids to work through a project.
We need to have a discussion about the project plan. We have collaboration time district-wide once a week. Our ultimate outcome is a packaging contest. They have a piece of chocolate and a hard candy, and their challenge is to develop a package for each of those candies. So our essential question is, how can we use properties and materials to solve problems? We use a learning map to map out the skills that the kids need in order to answer that question. So when you look at the background skills underneath of that, kids have to be able to understand useful properties of materials.
One thing we need to talk through is how can we start to get them moving from identifying properties and observations of solids, liquids, and gases into how do you observe properties of different materials?
So that's where we came up with, like, let's try something with the chocolate. They need the background knowledge for our packaging.
We have got to do some observing on chocolate to see what else we can learn about it, right? What are some things that we could observe?
Like the texture, if it's like smooth, rough, bumpy.
With the chocolate lab, it was guiding them through, how do I observe things? How do I compare different materials to see what my results are going to be? And then now what new questions do I have and what new investigations do I need to do?
I'm going to bring you a piece of paper that has a blank chart. We're going to fill out our chart with these things that you already identified as things you want to observe.
This one's like medium.
Yeah, medium.
Sizes. How do we spell them?
So we're taking that science standard, like a property of a material, and we're trying to bring it to their level and show them where it is in their real world. And we're really working on the science and engineering practices. How do we act like a scientist? How do we ask good questions? How can we make good observations? How can we organize our thinking? How can we plan investigations? And it's always dialing back to, why are we learning what we're learning? So having that learning map really helps to be able to do that.
Oh, and then the inside.
Made the
boy,
oh,
made the
dark inside.
Yeah, the laughable.